Unfortunately, when we looked at the U.S. elections in the midterm and then now heading into the 2020 election cycle, unfortunately, we have found a lot of somewhat disheartening and disturbing political advertisers.
The online political advertising business, particularly on social media, is a really big business. It's over $500 million a year on Facebook alone. Candidates are really big spenders on all of these platforms. They use them particularly to raise money.
The major ones that appear to be used are the major ad platforms in general online. So Google, Facebook, Twitter, Yahoo, now Oath, Ad Network are largely used for online political ads. If we judge by the spending related to online political advertising, we can see that it's growing pretty much exponentially each election cycle.
After the 2016 disinformation campaigns became public and, you know, became scrutinized by Congress, all three of the major platforms created transparency archives that were designed to give the public at least some way to see political advertising on those platforms.
This transparency project almost emerged somewhat opportunistically. Facebook in particular, but also Google and Twitter, had pressure applied to them from the US government and from other governments now across the world to become basically more transparent and work more with outside parties to help combat election interference, disinformation around political advertising.
At this point, we're able to collect all of the data that the platforms publish.
So we're trying to build algorithms that won't just find, you know, Democrats doing these kinds of campaigns, but also Republicans, basically neutral algorithms that will look for just kind of generic signs.
We actually just wrapped a project studying the Canadian federal election of 2019. We, you know, overall saw better transparency from the political parties and from the candidates. They were very clear about who paid for ads.
If you're worried about these types of repercussions like stalking and bullying, it is worth kind of learning how to configure your privacy online.
One of the real benefits of our project is we are making the data that we collect available to other researchers. You know, you go through this very hard process with the data collection and with the cleaning and the analysis, but it doesn't just help you, it helps many, many people.
Ideally, this will be effective at training the younger generation to realize that A, it's their responsibility to be able to pick out these disinformation campaigns, and if they kind of participate in them and, you know, like them and reshare them and things like that, that they're actually potentially harming the overall society that they live in within here.